everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all having a wonderful day. This is a makeup collection video. I have done a few of these in the past, but I've just completely redone all of my storage. I've gotten rid of my old drawer units and I replaced them with a brand new one. New drawers are from IKEA. I believe they are called Malm, M-A-L-M, and it has 6 drawers. The other drawers were just too narrow, too small, did not fit enough stuff in, and all of my little kitchen, like little storage containers in the bins, didn't fit snug in the drawer, so I was just wasting space. These ones, the little bins that I've got now, fit perfectly in the drawer, so I'm making use of all of the space in the drawer, and I can fit so much into one drawer rather than having a million different drawers for all different little things. I'll leave all of the info and link the particular drawers that I got in the description box. But just briefly, before I get into the actual collection, I just wanted to announce something extremely exciting for me. Like, this is so exciting for me and I cannot wait to share it with you guys. I kind of already have on all of my other social media platforms, but not yet on YouTube. So basically, I have a new website. I haven't ever had a website before. This is the first one that I've ever had. The website name is www.lovelos.com. And on this website, you'll find everything from beauty to fashion to lifestyle to advice to travel tips to anything that is on my mind at the time, anything that I want to share with you guys. I'll be posting 2 to 3 times per week. I'm still going to be filming on YouTube. I'm not neglecting that, but I will also be having this whole other platform for new content and different stuff that I can't really, you know, talk about or discuss on YouTube because it's a different kind of platform. So I'm really excited to be able to give you guys fresh, new, exciting, and different content. And I will eventually be having exclusive videos to the website as well. I do have a little mailing list and a subscription area that I will link below if you do want to get updated on all of the latest stuff on my website. But I'd love to hear you guys' feedback. So what you think, if you have any recommendations or any posts you'd like to see, because obviously this website is for you and I want you guys to love it as much as I do. So yes, I'll link that all down below, but enough talking and let's get on to the collection. So I'm not going to show these drawers in any particular order. You can get these little kitchen bins that I've used here, these little, I'm not even sure what you would call them, little containers, storage containers from, well, these ones are from Bunnings and they range from about $1 to $3, so they're much cheaper than the ones that I used to use, these little acrylic ones. I think you can also get them from Kmart. They're so basic that I'm sure you can find them pretty much anywhere. And of course, this is just an IKEA drawer unit, as I said earlier. And what I love most about these little storage containers is that I can fit a certain amount in perfectly. There's no little gaps along the sides, which is what I hated about my old storage. There was lots of gaps, so everything, like, you kept on moving around when I opened and closed the drawer. These ones are really, really tightly packed, so, like, as you can see, they're not moving at all. So you can make most out of the drawer space. So in my little brow section, I've got clear brow gels. I'm not going to go through all of the brands because that's going to take way too long, but hopefully you'll be able to see some yourself. Then I've got pencils, retractable pencils, a little Stila liquid pen type thing, some spoolies, tweezers and brushes, and then in this little separate one I've got the little gel, brow gel, what are they called? The dip brow pomade and those other similar products, and then powders, more powders, loose powders, and then a little kit as well. Here are mascaras, so that's pretty self-explanatory. Obviously nobody needs this many mascaras, nobody needs this much makeup in general, but I just keep them all in here because it's fun to be able to change it up every now and then and not always rely on the same product. And then here I've got some sharpeners, some makeup store, mixing liquids, primers. Here I've got all of my black liquid eyeliners, so I wanted to separate those because I tend to use liquids more often and all of them tend to just blend into one another, so it's hard to find which ones are liquids and which ones are pencils. So then here, of course, we've got pencils, all different types of pencils, jumbo crayons, retractable ones, the soft coal ones, and then the long-lasting ones, so it's just all thrown in there. Then I've got gel eyeliners, so just a different array of brands and colours, and then 2 little cakes, the little brow powder cake things. Here I've got all of my like brown kind of chestnutty liquid and pencil liners, and I've got some lighter kind of creamy champagne-y shades, yellows, the colors that go in your waterline, and some golds.
Then over here, it's pretty obvious, I've got some like different shades of blue, so aqua, turquoise, dark blue, navy, light blue, etc. And then we've got green, and I've got all of these mixed up in terms of drugstore and high end, because as I said before, it's too hard to separate them all into like sub categories, so I just keep it as it is. Then over here, this is just my whites, my silvers, my like dark kind of graphite shades, and then this is my favorite part of the whole entire drawer, all of my glitter eyeliners. These are absolutely stunning. I don't know if you can see them. The ones from Makeup Store are my absolute favorite, and this one is from Urban Decay, but they are absolutely stunning. I don't get around to using them as often as I would like to. And then here I've got some glitters. Now, a little tip, in this corner, if you do choose to buy this particular drawer unit and you use these little bin things, nothing's going to fit in this corner here. So what I did is cut one of these smaller ones down the middle and then just join them in, just push them in together, and then it makes a little smaller one. So that's really, really satisfying because it means you get to use all of the space. This drawer contains all of my palettes over here, and then all of my backups along the corner, and then in the middle, all of my lashes. Start from this side here. Got all of my NARS pressed powders in Beach, some backup lipsticks, Stila, Makeup Store, NARS Concealer, MAC Lipstick, Professional, Brush Cleanser, Bobbi Brown like concealers and correctors that I've had for a million years, so I probably should throw out, which is a massive waste. A paint pot, foundation, lipstick, blah blah blah, etc. etc. powders, and some L'Oreal True Matches. Then I've got all of my lashes. This is something that I got sent from Velour Lashes, which is awesome, and these lashes are stunning. I actually got a discount code for Velour Lashes that I'll leave in the description box. I think my favorite ones are these ones called Flairy Tail, and My Life's Complete. In this little section, I've got all of my red cherry lashes. These are probably my favorite brand of lashes, just because they're so affordable and there's such a huge range, and all of my favorite lashes are made by them. My favorite lashes are the number 47s, the 48s, and they're underneath here somewhere. Yes, the 138s, which are just a bigger version of the 47s. Despite being so cheap, also affordable, you can actually get quite a few uses out of them as long as you take good care of them, which is awesome. So next section are my Velour lashes. So I've got, oh, and some little tools. I've got my eyelash adhesives, some more glue, some Andrea strip lashes, some Glam Eyes lashes, and then these are all just my favorite Velour lashes. So yes, very, very pretty. So away from here now, I've got these little Too Faced cute little palettes. I got these, I think they were like a holiday collection, like a Christmas collection type thing. Then I've got some Chew Chew palettes. And then in this little container, even though it's one of my old containers, it was the only thing that could fit in here, I've got all of my little smaller palettes that I didn't want to be just thrown in there. Then I've got some Sigma palettes, Urban Decay, lots of Too Faced palettes, The Balm, It Cosmetics, Too Faced, and these are just the Z palettes that have all of my depotted eyeshadows in them. Palettes are the hardest to organize because you can't really put them in these little containers, you just got to stack them up, so that's why they're all in different, kind of going different angles, because I just wanted to make it like a nice straight down the middle section so that it's just all over there. This drawer contains all of my lipsticks, lip glosses, and lip liners, obviously. This is probably the hardest drawer to organize because I need way more of these lipstick holder things, and I just don't have them at this stage, so I had to kind of, you know, improvise with this bit here and just stack them all in there. And I still have like basically another little one of these full of lip glosses that need to find a home. So here we have some Maybelline Color Drama, what are these even called? Intense Velvet Lip Pencils. And then I've got some stains and tints from Benefit. This little section here was originally sectioned off into two, one being like lip balms, like colored lip balms, and one being stains and tints, but I just didn't have enough room, so I've had to combine the two. So that's pretty much what it is, just these kinds of pencils, and then some lip stains from Chi Chi, Yeah, just basically a mixture of those two. Here I have all of my like nude pink salmon shade lip glosses that you all know I love. It's just easier if I separate them because I reach for them more often than my brightly colored ones. So I just thought, yeah, why not separate them? This little section is all high-end lip glosses and liquid lipsticks. I did want to have these separated into lip glosses and liquid lipsticks, but as I said earlier, I just don't have the space. So Too Faced, and then I've got some OCC Lip Tars, Laura Mercier, Too Faced, Urban Decay, Bare Minerals, Fila, NARS, Smashbox, Napoleon, Kat Von D. Then in here, I've got all of my drugstore lip liners, so lots of different brands and shades there. And then in here, it's weird, all of these ones, all of the drugstore ones fit perfectly in this bin, but all of the high-end ones seem to be too long. Anywho, this is just a mixture of, high-end lip liners, pretty much all different shades, mainly nude shades, because that's what I wear most often, yes. Then in here, I have drugstore liquid lipsticks. I wanted to put these into a separate little bin because I absolutely love liquid lipsticks. I never really wear lip glosses because they annoy me because my hair gets stuck to them. But liquid lipsticks tend to be a lot more easy to wear. So all of them are in there. Got like L'Oreal, Chi Chi, Milani, NYX. That's pretty much it. Oh, that's Lime Crime. I shouldn't have that in there because I'm not using their products ever again. This one, I've got basically, most of those I think are actually high-end lipsticks, and they're just too long and too skinny to fit in those little holders because they just go they just rattle around everywhere and fall out, so I just kept them in this little separate section. And then here are just pretty much all drugstore. With this one, I had a weird space here, so I just, again, cut up one of these bigger bins and just basically kept cutting it until it fit into this weird little like Z shape type thing. Here are some Anoxa lipsticks. Those are definitely ones that I think I have to throw out soon because I haven't used them in a million years, but they just fit so nice and evenly into the little holders that I just can't throw them away. Here I've got Maybelline lipsticks. Yeah, so these are my MAC lipsticks, Lime Crime. Well, actually, I mean, I'm gonna put that one back because realistically, I'm never gonna buy their products again, but I'm not going to throw out the ones that I do have because that's just wasteful. So I do have those there, but if you don't know the whole drama with Lime Crime, I definitely suggest you Google that because it seems like a very corrupt company. Anywho, I've got some Zoeva lipsticks, Bobbi Brown along here, some Face of Australia. These ones here, these gold ones, are all my YSL lipsticks, and then those are some Elizabeth Arden's, Giorgio Armani, YSL, Stila, and then these are all Chi Chi, and those are all Chi Chi there as well. These are Maybelline, those are Makeup Forever, these are all Makeup Store, and yes, Too Faced, and that's pretty much it for that drawer. I'll start here. These are the primers that I don't really tend to use. Well, the Makeup Store, the Laura Mercier, and the Hourglass I do use, and I love those ones, but they are too long for these bins here, so I just put them in this long one. But the ones up here I don't really use. But these ones I do use more often. So, got a Stila, NARS, L'Oreal, Professional, Benefit, L'Oreal, Inoxa, Stila, Marinus, and Hourglass. My favourite would have to be the Hourglass one. And then I have some foundations here that I don't use very often either, but I still do like. So it's CoverGirl, Juicy Moran, Hourglass, Laura Mercier, Hourglass, Kat Von D, Makeup Store, Bobbi Brown. These are the ones that I bought from the States that I thought would be the same shade as the Australian ones, but they are not, so I never really use those ones. And then I've got a Too Matched Lumi, Napoleon one that's too dark, and a Revlon one that I bought in the States and I still haven't gotten around to using because it is quite dark and I don't really fake tan that dark these days. So in here I have some concealers. These are all of my little round pot ones and my little palettes. So Sonia Kashuk, Napoleon, Purtis, Makeup Store, Laura Mercier, MAC. That's MAC paint pot, so I'm not sure why that's in there, but well. Laura Mercier, NYX, Bobbi Brown. And then all of these ones are long skinny ones that I don't really use as often. So we've got By Terry, which I do really quite like. Yves Saint Laurent, I like that one too. L'Oreal Mercier, True Match, then just some other Laura Mercier and other mixtures in there. These are my foundations that I use all the time. These are my favourite foundations. I have to say my holy grail at the moment, my favourite foundation is the new NARS, I'm not even sure what it's called. All Day Luminous Weightless Foundation. There we go. All Day Luminous Weightless Foundation. What a long name. And I'm in the shade Medium 1 Punjab. Next is my second favourite foundation, which is the L'Oreal Infallible that has definitely replaced my L'Oreal True Match. Just better coverage, better colour, better finish. Just love it. Maybelline Fit Me. Giorgio Armani, which I'm also very fond of, the Giorgio Armani one. Bare Minerals, Bare Skin. Now this, if the NARS one didn't work for you, definitely give the Bare Skin a try, because in my opinion it's pretty much the exact same, just the Bare Minerals is like even lighter and uses weird ingredients like coconut water and stuff like that, or I don't know, some weird ingredients anyway. Laura Mercier, Makeup Forever, and then these are my favourite concealers in here. Been recently obsessed with the Naked Skin by Urban Decay. Then Maybelline Fit Me NARS Creamy Concealer in Custard, and the True Match. Over here I've got liquid bronzers. I've got all of my Urban Decay ones here. Then I've got some more powders. This one is from Australis, Bare Minerals. I have to replace this one with my new one that I just got. That's just the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder. Then I've got Makeup Store, MAC, NARS, Makeup Forever, Miraness, and MAC. So this drawer obviously contains all of my single eyeshadows. So yes, again, in the corner I just did one of those little cut the bin in half and put it together. Haven't totally filled up that little section, but it will be full soon, I'm sure. All of these are from Chi Chi, and all of these ones are from Makeup Store. Then I've got up here some of my NYX single eyeshadows. I have like a million more of these, but they're in my my Z palettes, so I haven't got around to depotting these, so they're just kind of chilling in here in the meantime. Then I've got some Body Shop stuff. These are all Max Factor. These are all MUA and Makeup Academy. I went through a massive phase of being obsessed with this brand because it's super, super cheap, but they've kind of passed a little bit. Then I've got some Sigma shadows that I never really use, and some Bourjois ones. So basically anything in this back bit here, I don't use as often. That's why it is up the back, because I don't reach for it as often, so it's not in a convenient spot. Here I've got all of my Urban Decay eyeshadows here. Then these are all Milani ones. Like this one is stunning. These are really, really nice eyeshadows. Here I've got some L'Oreal ones as well. And then some glittery Urban Decay ones. Then I've got, this is just probably the cutest thing I've ever laid eyes on. So these are the little duo NARS eyeshadow palette things, and this is the single one. I'm obsessed with little tiny, like small things, like the small version of big things, if that makes sense. So when I got this, I just lost it. It is so tiny and so adorable and stunning in itself. The colour is really, really nice, so that'll be fun to use eventually. Anyway, so obviously those are some NARS little duos, and then I've got some Tom Ford eyeshadows. These are stunning. They're really, really nice. You got like a matte shade and like a shimmery and then like a glittery shade. Bobbi Brown, Laura Mercier, and then another YSL one, which is really, really nice. Here I've got some Calvin Klein eyeshadows. These are also really nice, but unfortunately I don't tend to reach for them as much as I should. Then I've got two Hourglass palettes. I'm obsessed with one in particular. It's probably this one. Yes, this one is beautiful. I love this second shade here for in the crease, and yes, beautiful, beautiful product. Then I've got some Milani baked eyeshadows here, a really nice red one, and then a kind of bronzy coppery shade, and then Milani. These ones are all very shimmery, and then some Essence ones behind there. Back here I've got some more Sigma eyeshadows, and then these are just little, MUA Makeup Academy, e.l.f., and then some other, brands. And I've got some Maybelline Color Tattoo pigment things. No, they're not a Color Tattoo. These are, Color Tattoo, pure pigment eyeshadows. And then the L'Oreal Infallible eyeshadows, which I am utterly obsessed with. These are amazing. Then all of these are makeup store. These are eye dusts. Yes, and these are in a league of their own. They are amazing. So they're all eye dusts and a little MAC pigment there. Then I've got some NYX loose pigments here and some CoverGirl. What are these? Bombshell Shine Shadows. They're just like cream eyeshadows, I guess. Over here I've got some Maybelline Color Tattoos, the cream eyeshadows, some Bobbi Brown long-lasting or long-wearing cream shadows, the Stila Magnificent Metals foil eyeshadows, and e.l.f., and then just a mixture of like Max Factor and NYX and Benefit and MAC. Yes, basically all in that little corner there. And these ones are Jordana Sparkling Cream Shadows. This drawer here contains all of my blushes, highlighters, bronzers, and loose translucent powders, and then some creams all up the back here. This drawer is actually quite empty as well, but it's good because it does give me the opportunity to expand into it and grow into it, so not going to be trying to struggle to fit new products in. This little section here basically relates to the previous, I think it was the previous drawer, I'm losing track now, or the one before that one, I think, that had all my powders in it. It just couldn't fit all the powders in that drawer. In here I've got all of my like matte contouring powders and my shimmery ones as well. So Napoleon, and then these are all just NARS ones, and then Makeup Store, Bobbi Brown, NYC, Rimmel, and Bobbi Brown. Oh, that one's actually from Model Co. And then Elizabeth Arden, Stila, Hourglass, The Balm, and this Charlotte Tilbury one, which is probably my new favourite product. Stunning! Amazing packaging and amazing product inside. I absolutely love that highlighter. Been wearing that all the time recently. And then just my old school Hoola by Benefit. In here I've got, this probably doesn't need to be in there actually, that's a highlighter. And these are all loose powder highlighters, so they're also like, so they're incredibly messy as well, so I don't really use them as often as I would like to, but they're still beautiful products. So that one's from Makeup Store, Models Prefer, I think, I'm not sure, I can't see properly, Models Prefer, yes, and then Eat Cosmetics, Shoot Umara, this one's from BH Cosmetics, Bourjois, Bobbi Brown, MAC, The Balm, and Hourglass. Next I've got my NYX blushes. This little section here is mainly drugstore blushes, with the exception of these Urban Decay Naked ones that didn't fit in here. So NYX, Jordana, MUA, Makeup Academy, and then just the other ones, NYC, etc. Then The Balm and Stila, and then these Urban Decay Naked palettes. Here I have some cream highlighters, so Makeup Store Napoleon. In here I've got a loose blush, and then the rest are all cream blushes. Then I've got all of my blushes in here that are all high-end. So these, I'm obsessed with these blushes. The packaging is absolutely ridiculous and adorable. And then in front of those I've got some Tarte Amazonian Clay blushes, and then Bobbi Brown, Benefit, Makeup Store, Urban Decay, Bobbi Brown, Shoot Umara, and then these are all MAC. In here I've got my Hourglass blushes, which are probably my favourite blushes to use. They just give it such a beautiful like glow to the skin. Then my Milani blushes, which I'm also absolutely obsessed with. Bare Minerals, all my NARS blushes, and then these are YSL blushes. In here I've got some more liquid or cream kind of blushes. These little Stila watercolor ones, which I still haven't used yet, unfortunately. And these NARS multiples, which, oh, that's such a nice color. Again, probably don't reach for as often as I should because they aren't powders. So that is the end of the collection. I hope you guys liked it. I definitely do still have a long way to go with my storage. This is pretty much like the biggest step, but I've still got lots of little steps. Like I've still got my
skincare and stuff that's all in the same storage, and it's just not complete yet, but I'll definitely do a whole like finished video when everything's done, and it won't just be a makeup collection, it'll also be like a filming setup, like a, you know, a whole makeup room setup and how I choose to do everything. So hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to check out my new website, lovelaws.com, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye guys.